Your people, deliver your people, God, that I will follow your message. Say, in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Let be seated in the presence of the Lord. This morning is a powerful morning. It's a glorious morning. It's a day of taking authority. Tell your neighbor authority. Tell your neighbor authority. Tell somebody beside you authority. Yes, this morning is a day of taking authority. We take authority over negative situations. We take authority over the enemy. We take authority over challenges of life. You take authority over that thing that the devil is telling you is impossible. And I want to announce on the mountain top, there is no impossibility before our God. And whatever is your situation this morning, you have come to the right place. Don't forget, this is the hour of solution. And this morning, you are going to take authority. Don't forget, it's a prayer program. And where there is prayer, everything is possible. And this morning, before we pray, I'll be speaking to us briefly on the topic, taking authority over the enemy. Let me hear a better amen. Amen. Let me hear a thunderous amen. Amen. Let me hear an amen that will put a quake in the camp of the enemy. Amen. Yes. Taking authority over the enemy. You can conquer the enemy. That negative situation, you can exercise authority over it. That oppression in your life, you can exercise authority over it. That person that is here and you are hearing strange voices, this morning you can exercise authority over that strange voice of the enemy. This morning is a day of taking authority. This is the mountain of the Lord. And we have not come to see the servant of God. He's just an instrument. We have come to meet with the God of solution. And this morning, I can assure you, if you can take authority this morning, if you can wrestle in prayer like Jacob of old this morning, if you can take authority, exercise authority in prayer this morning, the enemy will bow before you in Jesus' name. Say, the enemy will bow before you in Jesus' name. What does it mean to take authority? We'll find answer to that question in the scriptures. Our text this morning is taken from the book of Acts. If you have a copy of the Bible, please read along with me. The book of Acts. Acts chapter 13. We want to see somebody that exercises authority. He came in contact with the power that be. He came in contact with the oppressor, with the powers of wickedness, and he exercises authority. I love that man. He's a man that knows what it means to take authority. And this morning, the Bible says that whatsoever we are written aforetime, we are greeting for an enemy. We are going to do like this same man. We are going to take authority. That yoke must be broken this morning in Jesus' name. Don't forget that this is the hour of solution. And I want to tell us the power of the Lord is here. The presence of the Lord is here. And this morning, the Lord will comfort for you in Jesus' name. A better amen. Acts chapter 13. Don't forget, I'm speaking to all before we pray on the topic, taking authority over the enemy. Acts chapter 13. I read from verse number 6. Acts 13 from verse number 6. And when they had gone through the eyes unto Paphos, they found a certain sorcerer, an enemy, an opposer, an oppressor, the one that will not let go, the one that delights in keeping people in bondage, in bewitching the progress of people, in bewitching families, the wicked one, an instrument of darkness and wickedness in the hands of the devil, an oppressor, a bewitcher, the one that is mighty and great in enchanting the life of people, the one that holds people in bondage, holds people's businesses in bondage, the one that holds people's destiny in bondage. They found a certain sorcerer, a false prophet, a Jew, whose name was Bar Jesus, verse number 7, which was with the deputy of the country, such as Paphos, a prudent man, who called for Barnabas and Saul, and desired to hear the word of God. But Elmas, the sorcerer, Elmas the wicked one, Elmas the papa, Elmas the enemy, Elmas that delights in oppressing people's life, Elmas the sorcerer, Elmas the wicked one, Elmas the opposer of good things, Elmas the one that will block the door, block the way, Elmas the one that will take people's destiny into captivity. But Elmas the sorcerer. And today we still have Elmas the sorcerer. They are everywhere. Elmas the wicked one. The opposers of the destiny of men. Elmas the wicked one. For so is his name by interpretation. We stood there. Is that what has been happening in your life? You go this way, there is blockage. You go this direction, there is blockage. You put hand into that business, nothing is happening. The other day somebody called me. He said, Pastor, nothing is working. If I'm going, I will just see cobwebs. Cobwebs. I go to that place before you know it, I will see cobwebs. I go that direction before I know it, I will see cobwebs. Pastor, nothing is happening. That's Elmas the sorcerer at work, bewitching that young man to the ministry of cobwebs. But this morning, I want to announce to every Elmas, this morning you are taking authority over them. Is somebody hearing me? I said this morning we are taking authority. We stood there seeking to turn away the deputy from the feet. Then Saul, who also is called Paul, feared